नमस्ते बिटिया, माई सेल्फ जेवीएन नेहा सैनी फ्रॉम फिजियोथेरेपी एंड डायग्नोस्टिक्स, ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी। हेयर आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू अबाउट द एनाटॉमी ऑफ द किडनी। फर्स्ट वी कंसिडर अबाउट द पोजिशन ऑफ द किडनीज। किडनीज आर रेट्रोपेरिटोनियल ऑर्गन्स, दीज आर पेयर्ड। पेयर्ड मीन्स देर आर टू किडनीज इन आर बॉडी, एंड रेट्रोपेरिटोनियल मीन्स दे आर लोकेटेड बिहाइंड द पेरिटोनियल फोल्ड। Each kidney lies on the posterior abdominal wall, lateral to the vertebral column. In the supine position, the kidney extends from T12 to L3. So this is the vertebral level of the kidney, that is extending from T12 to L3. T means thoracic vertebrae, L means lumbar vertebrae. The right kidney is slightly lower than the left kidney because on the right side we have liver, which is of large size. And with contraction of the diaphragm during respiration, both kidneys move downward in a vertical direction. So one high of vertebra, that is 1 inch, 2.5 centimeters. So the anatomical features include the color, shape and dimensions. The color is reddish brown, wing shaped organ, and the dimension is 11 centimeter into 6 centimeter, and width is 6 centimeter, and thickness is 3 centimeters. So although they are similar in size, shape, the left kidney is slightly longer and more slender than the right kidney and nearer to the midline. Each kidney has two ends, that is the upper and the lower. In the diagram we can see, this is the upper end, this is the lower end, and two borders are there. This is the convex outer border and this is again the inner border. So the convex border is on the medial side at both ends, but in middle there is a vertical slit on the medial side. This slit is known as hilum, where we can see the emergence of the pelvis of ureter. Internally, the hilum extends into a large cavity which is known as renal sinus. And the two surfaces are there in the kidney, that is anterior and the posterior surface. Now come to the hilum and renal sinus. Hilum is the area in the kidney which transmits the various neurovascular structures into and out from the kidney. These are renal vein, renal artery and pelvis of ureter. So this is the hilum. And the arrangement of these structure from anterior to posterior side is, most anteriorly we have vein, then artery, then pelvis of ureter. Also lymph vessels and sympathetic fibers also pass through the hilum. Renal sinus. So renal sinus contains the upper expanded part of the renal pelvis, and the perinephric fat is continuous into the hilum and the sinus and surrounds all these structures. So this is the renal sinus, which is we have demarcated with the red color. This is the area within the kidney, and renal hilum is the area that connects the sinus to the perinephric space. And this is the frontal section of the kidney. Here we can see the interior of the kidney, the major and the minor calyces, all are demarcated. Then the renal pelvis, which is lying in the renal sinus, then the pelvis of ureter, and then the ureter. Now the coverings of the kidneys. Kidney has four coverings from inside to outside. The innermost covering is the fibrous capsule, which is very closely adherent to the surface of the kidney. Then outside it we find the perirenal fat, which covers the fibrous capsule. Then renal fascia, which is the condensation of areolar connective tissue that lies outside the perirenal fat and encloses the kidney and the suprarenal gland. Then outside that we have pararenal fat. You can see this also in diagram, the location of perirenal and the pararenal fat. This is the pararenal and this is the perirenal fat. So we discuss about pararenal fat. It lies external to the renal fascia and is part of retroperitoneal fat. So last three structures support the kidneys and hold it in position on the posterior abdominal wall. If there is deficiency of these three structures, the kidney will fall. Now the relations of the kidney. On the anterior side, that is in the front of the kidney, they are related to numerous structures. Like on the left side, the kidney is covered by, on the anterior side, by the left suprarenal kidney gland. Then below that we have stomach, then spleen, pancreas, and the descending colon, then jejunum. and these relations on the right side are, the topmost structure is on the anterior side, that is the right suprarenal gland. Below that we have the liver, then descending part of the duodenum, then right colic, flexor and the small intestine. Then we come to the posterior relations of the kidney. On the posterior side, right and left kidney, they have the similar structures, except that on the right side there is only one rib related to the posterior surface of kidney, that is the 12th rib, and on the left side we have two ribs, that is 11th and the 12th ribs. Then the topmost relation on the posterior surface is by the diaphragm. Below that we have three muscles. Medial most is psoas major, lateral to it is quadratus lumborum, and the lateral most muscle is transversus abdominis muscle. So these posterior relations are very important, kindly remember them. Then next we have vertebrocostal and renal angles. So it is the angle between the last rib, that is the 12th rib. This we have demarcated in this image. This is the 12th rib and the lateral border of the erector spiny muscle. This is the renal angle. This renal angle has its clinical importance, is that the tenderness in the renal angle is suggestive of the renal pathology like renal stones, renal abscess, pyelonephritis, etc. So the interior of kidney is divided into outer cortex and inner medulla. In the cortex we have the lobes of kidney like pyramid, these pyramidal structure, triangular structure, and with their overlying cortical part. So renal cortex is divided into cortical arches and the renal column. Cortical arches are the cortical lobules which forms the caps over the bases of the pyramid. And cortical, in this diagram we can see the cortical arches. The above the triangular area, the area is known as cortical arch. And between the triangular area, this is the renal column. So the renal column is the area which dip in between the renal pyramids. Then other than these, here we have outlined another interior of the kidney, that each kidney consists of renal cortex and renal medulla. And in the cortex we have the continuous band of pale tissue which completely surrounds the renal medulla, and there are extensions of the renal cortex to the renal columns which project into the interior aspect of the kidney as the dividing the renal medulla into discontinuous aggregations which are known as renal pyramid. So in the medulla you will find these triangular areas, these are known as renal pyramids. Since they are pyramidal, so they have apex, base. The apex of the renal pyramid is directed towards the renal sinus and the base is directed towards the cortex. So in this diagram, this is the base and this is the apex. The apical portion is surrounded by minor calyx. So in the diagram we can see the minor calyx location and the renal sinus. Several minor calyces unite to form major calyx, and two or three major calyces unite to form the renal pelvis, which is a funnel shaped superior end of the ureter. If we see the microscopic structure of the kidney, you will find their kidney is made up of collection of millions of uriniferous tubules, and these are known as nephrons. Each kidney contains about 1 million nephrons and thousands of collecting ducts. And this is the structure of the nephron. Here we can see a cup-shaped structure known as Bowman's capsule. This Bowman's capsule is occupied by the network of artery. This is known as glomerulus. This has two ends, that is, one is the afferent arteriole which is bringing the blood towards the nephron, and this is the efferent arteriole. So other than this, the next part is the PCT. PCT means proximal convoluted tubule. So this proximal part, which is highly tubular, highly convoluted, this is known as proximal convoluted tubule. This lies in the cortex. Then in the medulla there is the U-shaped part, U-shaped loop of the nephron lies. This is known as the loop of Henle. Then the descending part, distal part of the nephron lies in again in the cortex. This is known as DCT, that is distal convoluted tubule. This directly opens into the collecting duct. So this is the basic structure of a nephron. So in the glomerulus, there is high pressure capillary bed is there, which is the site of blood filtration. And the Bowman's capsule is just a funnel-shaped structure, funnel-like structure, which is the beginning of the nephron. So nephron has its own independent blood supply, which is by the renal arterioles and venules. So these are the basic steps in urine formation. For example, first step is glomerular filtration. So in the number one, which is demarked in the diagram, it is the glomerular filtration, which is occurring in the glomerulus. Then the second step is the tubular reabsorption. It removes the useful substances from the filtrate and returns them to the blood for reuse. Then the third step is tubular secretion. It adds the waste from the blood to the filtrate. And the fourth step is the water reabsorption. It removes the water from the filtrate and returns it to the blood for reuse. Then this is the juxtaglomerular apparatus. Juxtaglomerular apparatus means the area where the cells of the DCT, distal convoluted tubule, get enlarged, which are close to the efferent arteriole. This area is known as the juxtaglomerular apparatus. So here we can see the area of DCT, which is close to the glomerulus. This area, in this area only, the cells of the DCT are enlarged. This area is known as juxtaglomerular apparatus. It is also contains the highly specialized smooth muscle cells, which are found in the glomerulus. Then we come to the arterial supply of the kidney. The kidney is supplied by the renal artery, which is a branch from abdominal aorta. So you should remember only the name of the artery. This artery divides into various segmental branches, which supply each segment of the kidney. Then we come to the segments of the kidney. In the kidney, we have 5 segments total. On the anterior side, we have 4 segments. And on the posterior side, we have the 5 segments. The name of the segments is apical, caudal, anterior superior, anterior inferior, and posterior. Then the blood supply of the kidney. Here we have demarcated the blood supply with their origin. You should remember only the names of the veins and the arteries which are supplying to the kidney. Then venous drainage of the kidney. The venous drainage of the kidney includes the right and the left renal vein, which are draining into inferior vena cava. Then the lymphatic drainage of the kidney. It includes that the lymph of the kidney drains into lateral aortic lymph nodes. Lateral aortic means the lymph nodes which are located on both the sides of the aorta. Then come to the applied. So it includes congenital anomalies like unilateral, bilateral agenesis. Means agenesis means non-development. So there may be the chances of absence of kidney on both the sides of the body. Then horseshoe-shaped kidney. This is the congenital disorder, which is affecting 1 in 600 people. In this, the lower end of the kidney, they are united and acquire the shape of horseshoe shape during the development. So this is the horseshoe shaped kidney. Then we have polycystic kidney. It is the continuation between the nephrons and the collecting tubules if they are failed to establish. So this will result into the formation of small pocket like structure which are filled with urine. So this condition is known as polycystic kidney. Then the next is acute renal failure. In this, there is sudden or severe drop in blood pressure, which results from blood flow to the kidneys from severe injury or illness. And in this, there is the working of the kidney is failed. That is why it is named as renal failure. It can be pre-renal, it can be intra-renal, it can be post-renal. Pre-renal means the blood is blocked in the renal arteries and it is not reaching to the kidney. इंट्रारीनल मीन्स इफ देर इज़ डायरेक्ट डैमेज टू द किडनीज बाय इन्फ्लेमेशन और टॉक्सिन फॉर्मेशन और बाय इन्फेक्शन. इन पोस्ट रीनल मीन्स डिस्टल फ्रॉम द किडनी, इन द डिस्टल पार्ट ऑफ द किडनी इफ देर इज ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन इन द यूरिन, इफ देर इज ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन ऑफ यूरिन इन द यूरेटर, इफ देर इज एनलार्ज प्रोस्टेट, इफ देर इज फॉर्मेशन ऑफ रीनल किडनी, सॉरी रीनल स्टोन्स, एंड इफ देर इज ब्लैडर ट्यूमर और इंजरी, देन इट विल रिजल्ट इन टू रीनल फेलियर. देन पैथोलॉजी ऑफ द किडनी इंक्लूड्स द नेफ्रोटोसिस, इट इज ऑल्सो नोन एज फ्लोटिंग किडनी. It is the prolapse of kidney where the kidney slips or falls more than 2 vertebrae lower than where it should be. And it's often treated with nephropexy. Nephropexy is the surgical fixation of the floating kidney or the mobile kidney. Then we have the renal stones, the stone formation in the kidney. Then the tuberculosis of the kidney because of myobacterial infection. Myobacterium tuberculosis, there is infection, there is known as, this is known as tuberculosis of the kidney. Then hemodialysis, if there is severe renal failure, then the blood is filtered with the help of this electronic machine. This procedure is known as hemodialysis. Then the questions which are important for exams, like write short note on internal structure of the kidney. So in this question you have to describe about the interior of the kidney, about its cortex, medulla and the structure of the nephron. Then the second question is posterior relations of the kidney, right kidney or left kidney it may become. So you have to discuss about the posterior relations of the kidney, all the structures which are on the posterior surface of the kidney. And then in the exercise, you have to draw this diagram well labeled in color. You have to label all these structures, and this is for your task. And this you have to draw in your files. Another question is draw this well labeled diagram of the nephron. So you have to label also this diagram in your files, and also use appropriate color for this diagram. So this completes our topic, the anatomy of the kidney. Thank you.